our tradition, and we should not be scared, and nobody should scare us because of virus. We want to eat, we have children to take to school. As much as we take precaution, but we should not become alarmists. We should not alarm the nation. We should encourage people to do their work, to go about their businesses and take precaution. And where it has been reported that one has it, move faster to a doctor. Moreover, they have said malariaquine, chloroquine, betabine, and all these connections that we have can treat this thing. So we don't want to get our people scared. Check on the old people who have lost their immunity. They might die of something else, and then you say this is coronavirus. We don't want alarmists and people who want to alarm the nation to come to a standstill. We have a nation to keep. We have a GDP to grow. Since our GDP is down, minimal, and government must encourage Kenyans, those particularly who have not traveled, to go about their businesses uninterrupted. I was surprised the busy Mombasa road being deserted in Kenya, when we have not even witnessed one death, not even one death has been reported. It is as if it is time of war. Most of us, we are scared of thugs. We are scared of so many things. We are scared with people with bundukis and pistols in the wrong hands, of which the government is supposed to fight than the coronavirus. Coronavirus, we will overcome it. I'm not discouraging that let people not take precautions. But as we take precautions, we must understand first and foremost that we are Africans. We must toil so as to eat. In the developed world, even during weather, people are given free food. Here, nobody is going to give you free food. People are going to die in their houses if we say we want to shut down. If Jesus was shut down, or he was closed somewhere that he should not go and die for us, and then he accepted that, will we be still remembering Jesus Christ? Churches are telling people, oh, we are closing down churches. Why are you there instilling fear in people? Churches are supposed to instill faith and hope in people and ask people to pray. Not to tell people run away, the world is coming to an end. And we have been told in the Bible clearly, during the coming of the Son of Man, who is Jesus Christ, people will run from, instead of going to welcome him. Churches must not also instill fear in people and become dramatists. They must instill faith and hope and ask people to kneel down and pray for the blessings and the invention of the medicine that can fight coronavirus. So this is what I wanted to say. We in the developed world, what we are saying, and I repeat this as a labor leader in this country and as an international labor leader, that let us not dramatize. Let us not think of shutting down the economy. This is a very vibrant economy. Kenya is a satellite of economic activities in this region. And let us not start dramatizing, because if we went down, it will not be easy for us to come up again. So, and we will affect the entire East and Central Africa and other nations that depend on us. And Kenyans are hardworking people, and where we don't have foreigners, or where people are not infected with the coronavirus, or where there are no doubts, let those factories work. Let people go and cut flower farms and do that under precautionary measures, such as the ones we are taking. Let's not talk like people who didn't go to school, or people who are not focused, or people who cannot be able to focus and monitor what will happen post-coronavirus. Where will people go? And how will we have a huge unemployment problem in this country? And how, if we lost the bigger opportunities we already have, how are we going to get those people who are unemployed again? We are going to produce muggers, we are going to produce... Already, we have a worst situation where this government cannot control border in cities. It has, they are unable to control. Kenya is no longer, and you see, as much as you see border borders and hawkers, that depicts a poor picture of our country. It shows how, it shows you how that country, how poor it is. And it is the highest time Kenya government must address this issue of border border. It's becoming a big menace in this country, and matatus everywhere. Instead of restructuring